goes faster. So creativity, turn off. Creativity has gone. Lots of people have a popular belief that the notion creativity has gone was originated in early Christianity, where that it's coming down from the creation by the God. But lots of people have got contradictions of it. That is, before Renaissance, people were afraid to talk about this because the creativity is a provision of God. Humans are not considered to have any ability to create something new, except expressing what was created by God. Greeks, similarly, simply rejected the concept of creativity. Even the greatest philosopher, Plato, said artist is imitating, not creating. And which gives a clear indication of how the religion and education can hinder creativity. Well, we'll go to a recent history. Pablo Picasso, the most influential and revolutionary artist, was accused as a womanizer, which is true because he married a 17-year-old girl when he was in his 50s and he had an affair of 6 weeks with a 30-year-old woman, and then in his 70s. And then he married 24-year-old, very beautiful young model, and just before, 2 years before, he got died. So he was criticized publicly about this disgusting behavior. His reply was, "The man who can stick to the same woman for more than 6 months has something radically wrong in him." You know, the conclusion that you can get out of this, my friends, is not that you can become Pablo Picasso, just becoming a womanizer, but the relationship with his personality type and his creative ability. His unrestricted nature in his thinking and his lifestyle was reflected in his personal conduct. And again, if you have seen the professionals who are in creative industry, you should have noticed the same. They think and behave in different ways. We'll go for a practical example. There was a 42-story building, so it's got 44 lifts, right? So the tenants of the building kept on changing because their employees turn up for work late and giving the excuse of lift is coming late, which is true. So the tenants kept on changing, and the management of the building kept on consulting architects, engineers, and all kinds of consultants, but failed. So there was an interior designer who noticed the problem and was always volunteering to help. The management kept on neglecting and allowed him to give a try. 2 days. So he said, when the crew came up for the Monday work, the lift was fitted with mirrors. And the lobby that was lifts are arriving at, they were also fitted with mirrors. The management was furious and the blame simply was went to the interior decorator. How can a lift move fast when it is fitted with mirrors? How absurd is this? Ultimately, that is the traditional thing that we have. And they had to take the defeat because the people who have been complaining start praising the management. "Ah, have you started new lifts? Thanks very much, they are moving really fast." So they called the interior director again and asked, "What is the logic behind fitting with mirrors?" He said, "When you are involved with something really important, you simply forget the clock ticking. Similarly, when you put a woman in front of a mirror, she forgets not only the clock, but the whole world." Management said, "Okay, acceptable. Okay, what about men? They also praise you." He said, "Sir, when you want to look at a woman, you can't simply keep on gaping at the woman. It's inconvenient, and it affects your dignity. But when there's mirror, you're looking at the mirror. And if you need, you have got a front view, back view, and side view. And you can still have a dignity and enjoy it." What I want to stress is, spoiled by all these serious theories and the technologies that we have learned, we forget to think simple and think creative. Again, Pablo Picasso has said, "Every child is an artist by birth. But the challenge is to keep an artist as he grows up." Thanks.
Thinking creative.